guys, welcome back to my channel. It's your girl Baby Okay, and I'm back with another video. Today's video is gonna be about me talking to you guys, ladies, baby. How to keep your kitty cat smelling good and how to lighten her down there too. Now I know a lot of us women want our coochies and pussies and vajayjays to be pretty. Who don't want a pretty pussy? Like, for real. If you don't want no dark spots and you just want it all one color and smooth, no bumps, no lumps, I'm just kidding. Keep on watching. I'm going to give you some tips and some tricks. All right. Thinking about you. Thinking about you. Okay, so these are some strategies that I do that help me out that I still do it. That is fantastic. So, like I said, who don't want a pretty pussy? Who don't want their private area just all one color? Who don't want to be smelling good all day? Like, seriously, who want to be at work and then you go to your friend house or whatever in your pen or whatever and you smell yourself? I know a lot of women. I know. You guys smelled yourself before and you just like, okay, she needs to wash, you know? And just, it's discharge, it's, you know, bacteria coming out of you, you feel me? But it's all about how to wash properly and what products to use to keep you smelling fresh, especially on your menstrual, ladies. Like, but we're gonna get into that later. Let's just get into what some products that's gonna, you know, keep her fresh and lighten her. The number one thing I like to do is exfoliate my body. You at least want to exfoliate your body at least 4 to 5 times a week. I do it 4 to 5 times a week. Normally, I really do it before I wax because that's going to be the best outcome of it. You want to exfoliate. My best exfoliator is Shea Sugar Scrub by Tree Hunt. It looks like this. You can get it from Walmart. I have like freaking 10 of them and it smells so good. This is the, which one is this? I don't remember which one is this, but it smells so good and it got turmeric in here and that's gonna go into the lighting area. Now, turmeric actually do help lighten and brighten the skin. So that's why I say this is really good to use. I use it on my legs, private area, basically my whole body every time I exfoliate. So you always want to exfoliate before you wash your body. Okay, baby. Now to wash your private area, this is what I use. And this has been my best friend forever, forever. Like, ladies, go on Amazon and get you some of this and stop fucking using Summer Eve, because this is 20 times better than Summer Eve. Like, if you want to feel fresh all day, if you want to be to work for 8 hours and then you're going to go see your nigga, but you don't have time to, you know, get a wash up, you won't have to because your pussy going to be fresh. We want the niggas to come back and the niggas to remember, like, her pussy smells the fuck bomb, okay? Period. So, I was using Summer Eve. I'm not even gonna lie. I was using Summer Eve because that was, like, the only really vaginal soap and wash I knew down there, whatever, until I got introduced by this. My cousin seen this on Amazon. She seen it by some strippers advertising it, not advertising it, but talking about it on YouTube videos, because you know they motherfucker ass be dancing and sweating and shit down there. They gotta keep they punanis clean and fresh. So I'm like, okay, if definitely they using it and they staying fresh and they dancing, flopping, all that shit, then I'm gonna try it and test it out. And you know, I got thrown off because I'm like, first of all, what the fuck? But then you try this, this is gonna be your best friend. Like, this is your best friend. I recommend this to my sisters, my friends, and they use it and they love it. And if you sensitive down there, it's still gonna work. It feels so good. It's like when you wash down there and it's just like a breeze, like a mint feeling. Like, it feels so good. when you use this, just come back to my video and tell me you was right, because this is gonna be her best friend down there. Stop using all this other shit down there and start using this to wash your poo poo 2 times a night, in the morning and at night, because it's gonna be fresh, baby. Okay, now every time I get out the shower, oh, first, when you wash, like I said, when you wash, now this is the wrong and right way to wash. I never really knew about this until I start really getting to, you know, taking really good care of her, like, you know, bringing the color back, all that, getting the razor bumps gone, all that. You want to stop washing like this. So when you're in the shower and you wash like this, you causing your hairs to, you know, start growing in whatever kind of way. You want to wash up and down, like this. Now, I wasn't, you know, normally I wasn't, you know, just wash, whatever. But you want to, you know, up and down to train your hairs to stay one way. So that way when you get waxed or shaved, you won't receive no more razor bumps. You won't receive none of that. It would be real nice and smooth. And your hairs will grow all in one direction.
All the shavers out there, I was a shaving cream. I was a shaver girl until I started waxing. You guys want to invest in one of these.
I got these from Amazon. Oh, it's still wet. I just used it. I got these from Amazon, and it was like, I forget, it was under $20. But the bristles is very, look at that, flimsy, so it don't hurt. And you want to just, whatever spot you about to wash, I mean shave, you want to just, you know, go in circles, go up and down for about 5 minutes, and then, you know, you start shaving or waxing. Bomb. It's gonna be bomb results. I'm telling you, the best ever. And I will have the link to this down in the description box. So when you get out the shower, that's the most important thing. That's gonna be, well, washing too, but the most important thing is gonna be, okay, what are you gonna do, put down there or whatever, to keep her feeling fresh down there. I know you'd be on the shift for 8 hours, you wearing leggings or whatever the case you wearing. You do not want to smell yourself. You do not want somebody else to smell you. You do not want to have on a dress and you sit in a car and somebody smell you. That's the wrong thing you want to happen. You never want anybody to be able to smell you and then it stink. Okay, so when I first get out the shower, the first thing I do is use cocoa butter. Any type of cocoa butter, that's what I use, and that's what's gonna help with the lighting so much. Cocoa butter, just regular cocoa butter with no scent. Then I go in with Rich Hazel. You can get this at Ulta. And this thing was only $10.99. As you see, it's still a lot in here. Now this, baby, is gonna bring your color like this. My private area is like, it's all one color, baby. This shit right here, just get like a little wipe, or even put a little on your hands, just put a little bit down there, not inside, but just on there. This is alcohol free. It says it right there. This is lavender scent, but the scent really don't smell, so it really don't matter about the scent. But this is what's gonna lighten down there. I put it on my sister's neck because she have discoloration and her neck is really lightening so good. So this is really what's gonna work down there to lighten her, to keep her fresh. You want to stop using, you know, perfume. I know a lot of women or girls I know use perfume. Perfume and sweat do not mix. You want something that's going to keep her moist and going to keep the smell from coming, whether if you have discharge or not. But you shouldn't have discharge, because this is what this come in, and you're not going to have none of that, period. So this is what this come in. This is Arm & Hammer deodorant, and this is the lavender scent. It's clear, smells so good. I got two of them, one for my armpits and one for down there. I got two of them, y'all. And let me tell you, you just put this all over her, not inside, but just on it. Your shit gonna be smelling fresh. Like, you follow these tips, you will have a pretty smelling ass pussy within like a month. I'm telling you, your pussy is gonna be smelling fresh all fucking day. All fucking day, like literally. Dead ass. Then I always put on one of these, which is panty liners, the scented ones, to really keep her smelling fresh down there. So that way, when I get off, if I really don't have to take a shower or really don't want to, I just want to go to sleep, I won't have to, because I'm not smelling down there, you know? I'm not stinking down there, you know? Even though I take a shower in the morning and night, but still, you know, you always want to smell fresh. I hate smelling people, especially after coming from the bathroom. After they was using it, I hate smelling them. That's my number one thing. Like, how do you use a bathroom and you come in and then when the next person's going, they smell you? That is horrible. But when I did have periods, I had a strategy, y'all. Now, for the girls who wear pads, a lot of y'all don't change your pads often. You guys want to change your pads often. When you see it's just like the blood's padding up, just change it. I won't say every 2 to 3 hours because some people bleed a lot. So I just feel like you need to start changing it often. So when I used to be on my menstrual, I used to have a pad, and then I put a panty liner on top of the pad. Then I would get some spray and spray it. That's gonna keep you from smelling so fucking good. You do not want to be at your nigga house or at your nigga family house or anywhere and you're using a bathroom and the next person go in there and smell fish and they just like, ugh, she's on her period. You're just gonna make your whole outcome just make you look like you stink, period. Like, I hate coming out the bathroom from girls that have menstruals and their periods stink. Like, you need to do something about that, because that shit is just so fucking disgusting. I hate that shit with a T, like with a fucking T. Now, if you use tampons, then it's different. You can't really do the strategy. You can't use this, but you also could spray your panties with this. So you use tampons, you could, you know, keep some spray on you, and you still could put some of this on you to still take away the scent, to where when you leave the bathroom, your pussy is gonna be smelling good. Like, period, you guys. Like, always be smelling good. Also, another thing, it's all about what you eat too. So drinking a lot of water will help lighting her. It will help with all that due to the baking soda, whatever. And I'm telling y'all, I keep talking about this because this is going to be her best friend. Y'all need to get some of this because this shit is the bomb, like the fucking bomb. Like, so just let me know if you guys got any of these items that helps you guys out from keeping your poo-poo from stinking and just keeping her smelling fresh all fucking day, literally all day. Let me know what y'all think. Let me know if y'all try them. Let me know if y'all gonna buy them, and let me know how it works for you guys. All right, bye.